will start in 10 seconds. That means correct. Half of the parameter will be 20 plus section 36. And we can see here, length is 4 more than width. Length is 20 and width of this number is 62. That means our answer is correct. Now, coming back to, so this much you have to prepare up to this one, second exercise, up to second exercise for this assembly test. Now coming back to all examples and all exercise question, please practice. Because test means up to this much question you should know very well. Now we'll see most important question, start mark question, sixth number. See, Champa, 1 second. Okay. So Champa went to a sale, okay, to purchase some pants and shirts, skirts, okay. When her friends asked her how many of each she had bought, she answered, now we'll see, now main thing starts from here. The number of skirts is 2 less than twice the number of pants purchased. Okay. Not so straight, but we'll read once again. Number of skirts is 2 less, means 2 less than twice the number of pants purchased. So what is, we can say thumb rule in these type of word problems? Always start with end. Always now you can start with end. So see, always start with end means take some x and y value from the end. So let us take number of pants, because she went on a sale and some pants and some skirts she purchased. So let the number of pants she purchased be x. Let the number of pants she purchased is x, because we don't know how many pants she purchased, x. Now one more thing is, two things are there, pants and skirts. So let the pants be x, because ultimately we know this is not, two unknowns are there, pants and skirts. So we can use x notation for pants and skirts y. Now coming from the end, we can say number of pants we have taken is x. So number of skirts will be twice, y, two less than twice the number of pants. So what will be the equation y? Because up to here now we have one equation. After this, we have one more equation. So two equations we'll have, because unknowns are 2, x and y. So we need two equations to solve the equation, to get the solution value of x and y. So y will be, number of skirts will be two less than twice the number of pants. Always this now, start or see from the end. So number of pants we have taken x, not double. Twice means double. So number of pants double is 2x. Two less than the twice. Twice we have done, and two less. That's why start from the end. Number of pants we have taken is x, then twice this number, the 2x, and two less. Two less means minus 2. This is equation 1. Understood, everyone? And you know, two unknowns are there. So this is the number of pants x and number of skirts y. So number of pants we have taken x. So number of skirts is twice the number of pants and 2 less. So 2x minus 2. Now coming to second equation from here also, the number of skirts means y is 4 less than, same pattern, 4 less than 4 times the number of pants. So y is, again start from the back, from the end we can say. So this is this sequence, pants we have in x. So 4 times will be 4x and 4 less. Four less, because number of skirts is 4 less. It is less, so we'll subtract here. It is less, it is more. So we'll subtract here, then it will be equal. Similarly, number of skirts were 2 less. It is less, and this value is more. So we'll subtract from the higher side. So these are the two equations. Help her friend to find how many pants and how many skirts Champa bought. Also, from the end also we can see, from in these type of word problems, in the end they will ask what things we have to find. So number of pants x we can take, always number of skirts y, and we can form the equation. First one was number of skirts, that is y was 2 less than twice the number of pants. So the number of pants was x, so twice of number of pants will be 2x minus 2, and 4 less than 4 times of the number of pants. So number of pants was x, so 4 times 4x minus 4. So solve this equation by any one of the method and let me know the answer, because in this question we have not mentioned graphically we have to solve or simply algebraically. So these are the two questions, solve and let me know the values of x and y. Everyone will try. Any one method you can use, substitution, elimination, or graphical method. This is second equation. And let me know the answer. Send your answer in chat. Okay, good, Shija. You got the answer. So Shija is the first one who got the answer. Ashish, Mohammed, Pratibha, Kritusha, Steve, Tanvi, Udhav. If you got the answer, then quickly reply. X equal to this much, Y equal to this much, or number of pants is equal to this much value, number of skirts equal to this much value. No one got the answer. Why it is taking so much time? Write IDK if you don't know. IDK. Write something, IDK or proper answer. Okay, so Steve, we have to solve also. We can use any one of the method of solving. Simple, okay, Tanvi, good, your answer is correct. Simple, to simply, simply we can solve by equating these values, because see left hand side, y is same. So simply we can equate both the equations, as simple as that. We can equate these two equations. It will not take more than 30 seconds to solve this question. Equating both the equations, because both are having left hand side y value, same. So 2x will go in right hand side, this will become 2x, 4 will come in right hand side, so 4 minus 2, 2. So from here 2 by 2, 1, x equal to 1, 1 value, and in one equation we can put x value. So let me take first one, so y will be 2 into 1, 2, minus 2, 0. So y will be 0. So what was x? X was number of pants. So 1 pant and number of skirts, 0. This is the answer. What was there in this question? This will not take more than 30 seconds. Okay, Mohammed, good, and Pratusha also, right answer. So x equal to 1, number of pants Champa will purchase will be 1, and number of skirts will be 0. Okay. So any one of the method we can use. We have this method was equating both the terms, because left hand side is y, so we can equate right now, because simple concept we have in maths, a equal to b and a equal to c, so that means b equal to c. A equal to B and b equal to c, that means b equal to c. This is our normal understanding, right? From the graph also we can see here this both the lines will cut, but here this is graph, they say solve by graphically, then we can draw the graph. Otherwise directly algebraically also we can solve by equating the equations or by linear method or the substitution method, right? So last question for today. The other questions you have seen, we have seen almost all the types of question. Last question for today will be sixth number. Seventh number also same, similar kind. These two equations are there, and coordinate of the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis, and shade the triangular region. The triangle will be, say, two lines are given. So suppose first line is like this and second line will be like this. So triangle will be here. Lines and the x-axis. Lines are this one, see, try to understand. These are the lines and these are x-axis. So this will be the required triangle like this. The two lines we can draw, and this intersection will be one point. And see, with the help of x-axis will plot, and this will be the required triangle. Coordinates we can write. Coordinates means three coordinates. This will be one coordinate, second coordinate, third coordinate. And shape the triangular region where we can shape easily. Same question you can try as one more. Sixth question will be last and final question for today. We'll see, and then we can end the session. Sixth number, try everyone. Seventh number, I have explained. Two lines will get, and intersection point will move. And this one, we'll see the region from x-axis. X-axis is this one, one line, two line. So this will be the triangular region. We can find the coordinates, and then we can shape the region. Then we'll solve the seventh number.
Find the points.
Points will be intersection points only. Points will be intersection points only. This is the point of intersection point of line 1 and 2. This is the point on x-axis. This is point on x-axis. Suppose, see, seventh number, let me try to explain in 1 minute. X minus y plus 1 equal to 0. So, question 7. X minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Okay. And second one is 3x plus 2y minus 12. So 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. X minus y plus 1 equal to 1. X minus y plus 1, 0. 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. So this we can, this from this now we get line L1, and we can plot the values. The values we can take x, y, suppose x value is 0, so y will be 1, because 0 minus y plus 1 equal to 0, y will go in right hand side, y will be 1. This time take y 0, very much a good option to take x 0 and y 0 in next time. Y 0, if you take x minus 0 plus 1 equal to 0, x will be minus 1. Let this point be a, this point be b. I am doing with some speed, so try to understand with proper focus. So x value is 0. You have taken y will be minus, y will be 1 because y will go in right side, so 1 equal to y, and then y 0 will be put, so x will be equal to 1. So from this second line L2 will come, and same table we can draw. Only 2 points we need, x, y. First take x value 0, always take x value 0 if it is feasible to for you to take x value 0, and second time y value 0. If you take x value 0 from here, 0 plus 2y equal to 12, we can write. So y will be 6. If you take y value, if you take 0, so 3x plus 0 equal to 12. Minus 12 will go in right hand side, it will become 12. Right, 4. These are the two values c and d. Now we can easily draw the basically this one, lines L1 and L2. So xy coordinate system, x, y, positive, 0, 1, 2, three, four, five, six. Here, one, two, three, four, five, six. We can, because now in y we have maximum value 6, in x we have maximum value 4, and x negative minus 1 also there, so minus 1, y no negative value. So we can start plotting. First one is a point 0 comma 1, x 0 y 1, so x 0 y 1 will be here. Then b is minus 1 0, x minus 1 and y 0, x 0 y 1 will be at y axis, and x minus 1 y 0 will be at x axis. We will join these two points and we can extend in both the directions. So this will get line L1. You can plot also, this is point A, 0, 1. After drawing this line, we can write AB value. And this line we got from first equation, x minus y plus 1 equal to 0. Now, coming to second equation. So second equation we get is C point 0, 6, x0, y6 will be here, x0, y6, and D point will be 4, 0. So this is the D point, 4, 0. We'll join these two points. You can join with helper scale, and then you can extend in both the directions. Not so straight. So this will be the line L2, and C and D points we can plot. This will be C point 0, 6, D point 4, 0, and this line L2 we got from second equation. So second equation we write just above it, 3x plus 2y equal to 12 will also be fine. 3x plus 2y equal to 12, or 3x plus 2y minus 12 equal to 0. Most important is the intersection point. So this is the intersection point, and this intersection point will be the, we can say, solution value. Not a solution value. So this will be the intersection point. Write point P, x value we can plot. X value will be, if you take equal interval, so x is 2, first we'll write x value, then y is 3, 2 comma 3. And other points we know. So what was the question? In question we have draw the graph of the equation, this one we have drawn, this was line L1, line L2, and determine the coordinates of the vertices of the triangle formed by these lines and the x-axis, okay. These lines means L1, L2. These lines means L1, L2 and x-axis, and shade the triangular region so obtained. So this is lines L1, L2. So we'll get this much. This is the required region. You can shade properly. This is the required triangular region. And coordinates we can write. So triangle we have shown. This is the triangle, and this will be required triangle. One line L1, this is line L2, and this will be x-axis. So all three will form a triangle. Hence, coordinates of triangle. Triangle name will be PBD. PBD are coordinates, basically are P point 2 comma 3 comma B point minus 1 comma 0. This is B point, and D point 4 comma 0. Suppose we have to find the area of this triangle. How we can find?
And we can use the delta equals half modulus, okay. X1, Y2 minus Y3.
That also we can use. Or simply we can write half into base into height. Correct. That also we can do. Half into base into height also. So base will be this much. This is the base. So what will be length? Total 4 and minus 1, 5, no, this is 4, this is 1, 5, correct. And height will be this much height will be this height, vertical height. vertical height is height, so height will be 3, not 2. Height means y coordinate 3. So 15 by 2 square roots will be the area of this triangle. Also, we can use half in half the indeterminant 2, 3, 1, minus, half, minus 1, 0, 1, 4, 0, 1. That is all separate method. This will see in our upcoming chapters. And you can take snapshot. And this is the sixth number you can try as homework because we have this triangle. So sixth number you can try as homework because seventh number was doubt question. So we have discussed. Or take snapshot quickly and we'll see. Otherwise, I will upload this answer in, as a PDF in this Google Classroom. From there also, you can this one check and verify. Sixth number, just I'm writing the answer. See carefully. Given the linear equation, this one, write another linear equation because this type of questions can come in examination. Write another linear equation in two variables, means in x and y, such that geometrical representation, if we represent geometrical representation, means by geometry, if we represent the pair of equations so far, means another equation we have to write, so they are intersecting lines. So how, what will be equation of intersecting lines? For intersecting lines, we know this basic concept that a1 by a2 will not be equal to b1 by b2. That is simple. So equation will be, we can say this, we can take double 4x, and this will not be double. So we can take 5 and minus 8, not an issue. First, minus 8, if you want to change values, then we can write plus 7 or any value. Just make sure a1 by a2 is not equal to b1 by 2. If you check, this will be a1 by 2 will be 2 by 4, not equal to 3 by 4. That means our answer is correct. Second one, parallel lines. So for parallel lines, we know a1 by a2 equal to b1 by b2 equal to c1 by c2. This we know. So accordingly, we can this one, write the second equation. So let me double all the values. So double means this will be 4x. This will be 6y. Sign will be same. Minus 16 equal to 0. Because if we double, we can do or triple also. Triple means all the value. This is also correct. All the value we can multiply with 3. So this will be 6x. Values means for first equation, we can multiply with 3. So 3x plus 9y minus 24 equal to 0. This is also it's not right answer because we can see the ratio. Ratio will be 2 by 4 for this one. 2 by 4 equal to 3 by 6 equal to minus 8 by minus 6. All will be equal to 1 by 2. That means parallel lines means it's not C1 should not be equal. Parallel lines means no solution. Parallel lines means no solution. So C1, C2 is not equal. That means it's correct. We can write plus. We can write plus here. That means it is not equal. Just try to put plus in. Very simple. Because at the end, it should not be equal. A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 not equal to C1 by C2. That means for parallel lines means no solution. Last one is coincident line. So coincident lines, we know lines will be coincident. That means they will coincide on each other. So infinite many solutions. A1 by A2 equal to B1 by B2 equal to C1 by C2. That means all the ratios will be equal. This time we can multiply this equation by 2. So equation become 4x plus 6y minus 18 equal to 0 because all the ratios will be 1 by 2. 2 by 4, 1 by 2. 3 by 6, 1 by 2. Minus 8 by minus 16, 1 by 2. Plus 1 by 2. That means equal. So we can say coincident lines or infinite many solutions. So this will be the answer.
Sir, why is it minus 18? Shouldn't it be minus 16?
Minus 18 because, sorry, minus 18 is wrong. Actually, 2 times you have to multiply 16 is correct. 2 times you can multiply, right? Still, 2 times you can multiply or 3 times also you can multiply. So this will be, if you want to multiply 3 times, means all the values will be in the same ratio. The 3 times you multiply, this will be 6x plus 9y minus 24 equal to 0, correct. So this will be 2 by 6 will be 1 by 3, 3 by 9 will be 1 by 3, minus 8 by minus 24 will be also 1 by 3. This ratio will be equal. So you connect many solutions, or lines will be coinciding, they will be overlapping. That is our basic condition. Ratios should be equal. So either we can multiply twice this equation 2 into 2 or into 3 to get coincident lines. That means root will have infinite many solutions. So a1 by 2 equal to a1 by 2 equal to c1 by c2. For intersecting lines, a1 by 2 not equal to b1 by 2. So here we have taken a1 by 2 is 1 by 2. 2 by 4 is 1 by 2. But derivative we have taken 5y. So 3 by 5 will not be equal to 1 by 2. And plus 7 or n value you can write here. And for parallel lines, we have no solution. Is a1 by 2 equal to b1 by 2 but not equal to c1 by c2. So we have multiplied with 2. So this will be 4x plus 6y and plus 16 because 2 by 4 is 1 by 2, 3 by 6 is 2 by 4 is 1 by 2, 3 by 6 is 1 by 2. And minus 8 by 16 will be minus 1 by 2, not 1 by 2, so not equal. Or we can write 3 times also, we can multiply, we can put here plus. This will be 2 by 6, 1 by 3, 3 by 9, 1 by 3, but it will be minus 1 by 2, so not equal. That means a1 by 2 equal to b1 by 2, not equal to c1 by c2, so no solution. Or you can say lines will be parallel, same thing. Write note the solution and you can end the session. Any other equation you can also form. These are one simple case, but answers can be different for all the students. Criteria or we can say conditions should be met. Fine. So you can end the session now. I'm also ending for myself. Thank you.